You gotta see this thing. There it is. An echidna. Oh, I thought that was a bird. It's not a bird. That's weird. What the hell is that? Black nipples. Huh. So is there such a thing as echidna porn? I guess not. Right? Okay, there's my koala.
I bagged the koala.
And he doesn't look like he's going to be doing anything for a while. Maybe a long while. Long while. What have you got? Oh, now you're going to be the superstar of this film. Okay.
So this is little Andy.
Really? Male or female?
This is a boy.
Uh-huh. About how old?
He's about 14 months old. 14, 15
uh-huh.
months. Okay.
What a cutie. Yeah.
Right.
Boy, this is the picture for the Australian Tourist Board.
Well, we normally bring them out of 10:30, 12:30, and 2:30. But you haven't had a good chance in between that. So.
Uh-huh.
But you get a good idea. You can have a look at his claws where he climbs up. That's they're very strong and they're climbing.
Oh my goodness.
And they're rather beautiful animals to work
and
with.
And they don't like any cold weather, or are they?
Oh yeah.
Do they shed winter, summer? And
no, they don't shed, but you'll find the Victorian koalas are a lot darker than the further north you go, the paler they are. So these guys, in the winter time, when they are in the trees, they turn with the back to the sun so it absorbs
uh-huh.
the heat. And in the summertime, they lay back in the trees with their white tummies.
Oh, to keep the heat off
them. Deflect the heat. So they use their coat very well for there. But also, the Victorian koalas are a lot bigger than the queens of the further north.
Oh, okay.
So our males will grow to about 14 kilograms
uh-huh.
and the females to about 8 or 9. And in Queensland, the males grow to about 8 or 9. So there's a lot of difference between them. So.
It's such a treat. This is such a treat to meet one.
They are
so
beautiful
nice.
Animals. They are wonderful animals. They are not aggressive like a kangaroo and a wombat
mm-hmm.
who come after you
mm-hmm.
if you're in his territory. Whereas a koala doesn't. It just tries to get up the tree. But then if you do trap it, or if you try to pick one up, a wild one, they'll bite and they will scratch. So, and they scratch quite effectively.
Yeah.
And they also bite very effectively because their incisors are chewing through very tough eucalyptus leaves. So they've got quite sharpish and they will hurt you. So.
And how long do they live in the wild?
They'll live up to about 14 years.
Oh,
like that.
Okay. Well, that's wonderful.
They can live to there. And their sole diet is eucalypt.
Right.
And to cope with that, they have a rear gut digestive system. So it takes about 2 hours to about 2 days to digest.
Mm-hmm.
And their... I was going to say about their food. I've lost my track of thought there, but they're not a lot of energy. Oh, I know. I was going to say they eat about a kilograms of leaves a day. So you can imagine how many leaves there needs to be for a kilogram. So we have to travel about 100 kilometres to get we bring the branches in.
Oh, okay.
And we have a cool room where we store them in.
That's a big problem back outside this country is to get the eucalyptus.
Absolutely.
There is some in California, but...
But it's mainly the wrong type.
Oh, is that right?
I know in San Diego Zoo they had koalas. and they got rid of them because they said it cost them more to feed the koalas than all the rest of the animals put together. So.
Well, thank you so much for bringing little boy out to come meet me.
You want to give him a nice little pat there?
Oh, right. Oh, that's such a cutie. Look at the little red lips too.
Yeah.
Oh, that's too funny.
Because they don't. People often say, "Oh, they've got little eyes," but they don't need eyes to see because they live amongst their food, so they've got very good. They can smell very well, and they travel between the trees. So they sleep about 18 hours a day in the wild.
Well, thank you so much again.
All right, that's a pleasure.
And I hope to see you again.
Yes, I hope so.
Okay, bye.
Bye.